In true ASJ fashion, I now present to you my rather long overdue review of Saint Asonia's first album, which just so happens to be self-titled as Saint Asonia. Bring on the intro! You want a chance to rewind, maybe change your one-track mind, but you're too afraid of changing, so you're locking yourself up in that safe place. Okay, before we get to the main review, a little bit of backstory on this band. After Adam Gontier left 3 Days Grace around 2013, he went on to help form the band Saint Asonia, along with a few other humans with musical talent. They then released their debut album in 2015, and let's just say they are absolutely astonishing. You know, in some ways I'm kind of glad that Adam left 3 Days Grace, otherwise we wouldn't have gotten Saint Asonia, but that's like a whole other matter, really. Anyway, with that out of the way, this album's track list is Better Place, Blow Me Wide Open, Let Me Live My Life, Even Though I Say, Fairy Tale, King of Nothing, Waste My Time, Dying Slowly, Trying to Catch Up with the World, Happy Tragedy, Leaving Minnesota, and on some releases, 2 bonus tracks, No Tomorrow and Voice in Me. And I'd just like to point out that the titles, for some reason, on the bonus tracks have been swapped on pretty much every platform that I checked, so the song No Tomorrow has the title Voice in Me and vice versa, even though listening to the songs clearly reveals that the titles should be the other way around. I'm not sure if that's just a genuine mistake that's just never been corrected, or whether it's some kind of deliberate choice that I'm just too dense to understand. But either way, it's confusing, so for the sake of this review, I'll be referring to the bonus tracks by their correct titles, logically speaking. Anyway, with that out of the way, what are my general feelings about this album? Well, it's good, for sure. No, I'm underselling that. It's really good. Not really the same style as 3 Days Grace, which is good because you wouldn't want another band that's basically just the same as them. Just because we have Adam here, it doesn't mean it needs to be a retread of 1X or anything. 3 Days Grace were already retreading that album themselves around this time. While Adam's the only member I have any familiarity with, the whole group is made up of people who came from other existing bands as well. So while I can't really say for sure, I think the band's music is the combination of talent carried over by each member, and it's all combined here to create something new. And these guys really hit on something special here, I think. Right from the first track on this first album of theirs, you can hear that they're already carving out a new style for themselves. Better Place is a great opener song, and I think you could see it as a sort of goodbye message from Adam to 3 Days Grace. Of course, that's just one possible reading of the lyrics, but there's going to be plenty more depending on who you ask. Either way, it's a really energetic and badass way to kick off the album. The next couple of tracks are also heavier and just as good. Blow Me Wide Open is a favourite of mine because the overall sound of the track is just amazing. It displays just what this band is capable of with both cool, funky, hard rock sounds and a broader, more larger scale soundscape in the choruses that slap harder than an Asian parent after their kid gets a B in their exams. For legal reasons, that was a joke. Please don't mob me or anything. Let Me Live My Life follows, and it's a really catchy, hard track. It gives me a very grungy feel, personally. But after these initial 3 tracks, the album starts to show its moodier side, which becomes quite prevalent throughout the runtime. Even Though I Say and Trying to Catch Up with the World are both good examples of this. They're both very cathartic, despite being quite downtrodden songs. I don't really have any experience with the blues genre, but from what little knowledge I have of that type of music, I'd call these songs like a rock version of the blues. The bonus track Voice in Me also has similar bittersweet vibes. Like most albums, this one has a good variety of tone to its tracks. There's the ones that I mentioned before that open the album that are very lively and vibrant. There's the mellow and cathartic ones like I also mentioned, as well as others like Waste My Time and Leaving Minnesota. Both of which have a friendly atmosphere that effortlessly pulls you in. Then there are some songs that balance sort of around the middle ground. These are pretty much all of the other songs that I haven't mentioned yet, and they all vary in terms of tone, ranging from being heavier and more aggressive to leaning in the other direction and being more positive and upbeat. And I think for the most part, the album carries it off brilliantly, although it isn't without its faults. Fairy Tale's chorus is quite repetitive, for example. And overall, while I do appreciate the slower, more serious approach to the music on this album, it isn't a style that I jump at the chance of listening to quite as frequently as I would with some others. That's not to say that the album is bad or anything, because nothing could be further from the truth, but my brain just tells me to put this album on less than other ones that I've reviewed on this channel. But on the plus side, that means that when I do listen to it, it always has a very substantial impact. Now I've got to try and narrow down which songs I like best from the album. This bit's almost always the hardest, if I'm honest. Don't
what you call defeat.
Well, I'm assuming I managed it. So overall, this is one of the strongest debuts for a new band I've come across. While I personally think their second album, which will be the subject of the next album review video, is even better, this self-titled work still does more right than wrong and is just a great listen from start to finish. I really couldn't decide what score to give Saint Asonia self-titled, but after some thinking, I'll be generous and give it 4 Minnesotas out of 5. What did you think of Saint Asonia self-titled? Do you agree or disagree with anything I said in this video? Do you want to just comment something random? Well, feel free to do any of those things and leave a like if you enjoyed and subscribe if you haven't already. Be sure to join me when I review Saint Asonia's second album, Flawed Design, which will hopefully happen sometime this year. We can only hope. Bye for now, humans!